rapping is easy, but can you open your mouth and say? Worship from your heart tonight. He's the greatest.
Mic check, mic check.
Well, can you hear me from the, can you hear me on the phone? No, you got to hear me from here. Oh yeah, here you go, here you go.
Mic check, mic check.
It's a little delay. It's good, we're good.
We ain't having it. It's a good day. Even though I cried last Tuesday and I was out of cash by Friday. No matter what comes next, I'm going to stand up and give it the praise.
Happy.
strength to believe that I
welcome to our live streaming services, midweek services from Park Avenue Missionary Baptist Church, where the Reverend Ellie Campbell is pastor. I just want to thank all of you for tuning in this morning, and we're looking forward to another fantastic lesson from our pastor. I want to thank the broadcasting team, for their good work this morning. We are continuing to work through our challenges, which are less and less. We want to give you a great streaming experience. So please hang with us and pray for us as we go along. I have a few things to share with you this morning. Then what I will do is we'll offer prayer. Pastor's asked me to do that for the sick and afflicted, the bereaved, and the convalescing. We'll do that in a few moments. But just a few announcements and some housekeeping. Don't forget to cover up when you go out. Make sure you're wearing your face mask and your gloves, and try to keep your going out to a minimum. But don't forget to get fresh air too. Go in the backyard, take your umbrella right now if you have to, get some fresh air. When things dry out a little bit, consider taking a walk. Those of you who have exercise equipment at home, make good use of that. So we just want to encourage you to do that. Keep the blood going, the blood circulating. When we're at home, we have a tendency to be sedentary, so we want to encourage you to do that. Also, stay in touch, stay connected. Reach out to our church family
members that you know personally or who are in your sphere of influence. We encourage you to call, to text, to send cards and video chat, use social media, all everything that's at our disposal. We encourage you to use those things. Right now, I want to share with you our calendar for this month. Every Friday, and this Friday particularly, we want to start our prayer call at 10 a.m. We'll be getting a phone number to you for those of you who want to join in. Matter of fact, I have it for you right now. And I'll say it a couple times. It's area code 605-475-4700. Again, that number is 605-475-4700. When you call that number, you will receive a prompt and asking for your PIN, the PIN number. And the PIN is 849-592. Again, the PIN is 849-592. And we look to have you join us on this coming Friday morning. Again, we just want to stay connected. We're also planning to teach Sunday school at the 10 o'clock hour on Sunday. Please stay tuned. That's to be determined when we will start, but our intent is to start at 10 o'clock with the teaching of the Sunday school lesson, and then 11 o'clock go into our morning service. And so on Monday, because we want to split our calls up, we want to have a prayer call on Monday at 10 a.m. also. We want to have, then we'll have prayer at our midweek service and then on Fridays. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday, we want to connect to the greatest extent possible. So we also want to remind you that on the 25th of this month, Pastor Campbell will be celebrating his birthday. And I thank you for the suggestions for that I received from two or three of our members. Under the circumstances, we won't be able to celebrate together as we do, as we have just about every year since Pastor came to Park Avenue. We won't be able to do that, but if you want to send birthday wishes, anything you want to send to the pastor, we're recommending that you send it to our the mailbox here at Park Avenue Missionary Baptist Church. And that mailing address is Post Office Box 56037. That's Post Office Box 56037, Riverside, California. And this is a long zip, so write this down. It's 92517-0937. Again, 92517-0937. And at the end of service today, before we sign off, we'll give that information again for those of you who weren't able to catch it. We want to now turn our attention to the sick and afflicted and the bereaved among us. We want to give a quick report on Deacon Elijah Williams, our chairman of the Deacon Board Emeritus, was taken to the hospital for some breathing issues. He has some breathing problems, but he was treated, and praise God, he's coming home. They've sent him home, so we praise God for that. And we learned this information from his daughter, Lolita. So we ask that you pray for Deacon and Sister Williams and their family. as we're praying for each other. We also want to remember the families that are going through bereavement right now. Sister Dolly Gibson and family, the family of Sister Dorothy Metcalf, the Hardy and Roberts families. We know that Pastor Hardy passed away recently as a result of the pandemic, but we also want to pray for his family. The last I heard is that Sister Hardy, Pastor Hardy's spouse, was in the hospital also. So we want to pray for our good members, Carmen and Greg, Keenan, and also pray for Adrian. Adrian is, she was also exposed. So we want to lift her up in prayer. Sister Betty Henry and family, they had a recent loss. And the family of Sister Dora Pickett, we want to remember them in prayer. Our individuals at home in convalescence, they're all, we want to remember them. The list is too lengthy for me to go person by person, but we certainly want to lift those up and lift those individuals up in prayer. I do want to mention, though, a deacon and sister, Deacon James and Sister Roberta Washington. Sister Washington is dealing with some health challenges now in her life, and we ask that you pray for her. And then remember Deacon Washington as he works with his spouse. So those are some of the individuals we want to remember. Remember each other. As I mentioned in the beginning, remember each other and pray for each other and stay in touch. We don't want to see anyone isolated, so it's very important for us to reach out. These services are important, and so we want to keep those things in mind. All right, with that said, we want to look to the Lord now on behalf of our sick, our afflicted, our super seniors, those who are bereaved among us. And oh, before I begin, we also want to remember our healthcare professionals, those who are on the front line, our emergency medical team, police officers, fighters, all these individuals who are on the front lines as we work through this pandemic. So remember them, please, and pray that the Lord will continue to give them the health and the strength to go forward. And lastly, don't forget to pray for our pastor. We pray for his strength. Pray for the leadership of your church. And we're going to continue in the best way that we can. All right, it's prayer time now, so let's look to the Lord as we ask for his mercy. Father in heaven, we come to you this morning. We thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercies. We thank you, Father, that you are omnipotent, omniscient, ever-present. You're immutable. Father, you're sovereign, and we realize that. We thank you, Father, for the privilege of assembling here to reach out to those that you have elected to be in this part of your vineyard. Father, we realize that our list of the sick and afflicted, the bereaved, those of us who have reached a good old age now, Father, we pray that you touch them according to your will. Father, we ask that you bless their families and that you be with them. Father, we're at a time, and you know this, and all this is happening according to your sovereign will, but we ask that you just help us through the aid of your Holy Spirit to look to you in this time of need, in this time of trouble. We thank you, Father, that you provided the opportunity and the wherewithal to reach out to the Park Avenue family. So we ask that you bless them. We ask that you keep them according to your will. And these blessings we ask in Jesus' name, and for his sake we pray, amen, and thank God. We want to, as the pastor gets ready to come forward, we want to thank you again for your giving. Thank you for remembering that the expenses of your church continue. We know that we can give in three basic ways. You can give by text, you can give online, or you can mail. We suggest that you mail your gifts, your tithes and offerings to here to the church. And again, I'm going to read that address. Is P.O. Box 56037, 56037, Riverside, California. And the zip is 92517, 92517-0937. That's 0937. So pastor's going to be beginning at Hebrews, the sixth chapter today. I'll be reading for him, and he is going to comment on the verses that we have that I'll be reading, and he'll be going through. We encourage you to text your questions. If you will text to Sister Dion Hicks, Sister Sandra Adieye, or myself, those of you who know those numbers, we ask that you text your questions. Pastor is willing to answer them, and this helps him connect with you when you ask questions. Now, those of you who don't have my number, it's 951-581-5802. That's 951-581-5802. Pastor, before you begin, there's a question from Sister Whitehead, and she's asking if 2 Corinthians 7:13 applies to what we see going on today. That's 2 Corinthians 7 and 13. See if I can find it and read it for you. And reading from the English Standard Version, it reads thusly: therefore we are comforted, and besides our own comfort, we rejoice still more at the joy of Titus, because his spirit has been refreshed by you all. For whatever boasts I made to him about you, I was not put to shame. But just as everything we said to you was true, so also our boasting before Titus has proved true. Let me go to 1 Corinthians and see if that was...
1 Corinthians?
Let me try that. That was 2 Corinthians.
Okay.
7 and 13. No, it must have been 2 Corinthians 7 and 13. Can you comment on that?
Well, all scripture is written for us and not written to us. And so we can apply this to our situation today.